Welcome, dear students, in the basic accounting lecture series. In this lecture, we explain different fundamental accounting assumptions. Fundamental accounting assumptions are the basic points which are accepted by all the accountants. Whether accountant is doing his accounting work in India or Italy or France or Germany, all will accept this. So this is a very common assumption which any accountant should follow, because benefit will be for the businessman. So we will discuss fundamental accounting assumptions. One is the going concern assumption. Going concern assumption states that the business is doing his work for long period. This period is not a 1 year, 2 year, 5 year, 10 years, not a 1 year, not 2 year, not 5 year, but it is the infinite time. Infinite time. Time. As per this assumption, business is going day by day, day by day, day and night, and there will not any effect of businessman for its stopping or restriction. I am teaching you how going concern assumption works. Suppose you are a person and you are doing one business. This is individual business. Individual business. Now you have two sons. One, two sons. And after your death, they make a partnership. And these two sons, this first son have three children, and this have four children. They make a private partnership or private company, and after doing a good business, and you will see this private company become a public company by listing it in the stock exchange and distributing the shares to the shareholders. So the lifetime of this company is 200 years. Life of this person is like 70 years. Life of the business is more than life of businessman. One of the benefit of this assumption that the trust will increase. Your creditor will give you the loan, books on credit, without any fear. When creditor fears that a business will stop within 2 days, he will not give you the loan or any goods on credit. So this is assumption will increase the goodwill in the mind of creditor. They think that other business is doing the business on the basis of going concern assumption. So we should not fear, and without any fear we have to give loan or credit, goods on credit. Second assumption is consistency. Consistency assumption. As per this assumption, the accountant will follow one method of accounting. For example, if he will calculate the depreciation, he will use one method, whether it is straight line or whether it is a diminishing balance method. If accountant will calculate the inventory, he will also use one method, whether it is INFO or LIFO or average method. If accountant is use the cash basis accounting, he should use cash basis accounting. If accountant uses accrual basis accounting, he should accrual basis accounting. Okay, if he will change anything on the basis of the law, for example, in these days only accrual basis of accounting is accepted for calculating net profit or net loss. So he, if in the past, if accountant was using a cash basis accounting, he should change it and he should disclose this fact in the footnote. Third is accrual assumption. As per this assumption, all the accountant will calculate net profit or net loss by including both cash and non-cash expenses and incomes. Cash expenses and incomes are very easy to calculate, but all the expenses which are due but not paid will also add in cash expenses. Like this, all the incomes which are earned but not received, so these receivable incomes also include in cash incomes. So bases are both cash and non-cash items for calculating net profit or net loss. But one important thing you must understand, not just one thing but two things. One is in accrual basis, any income which are not earned but received in cash will not include, and any expenses which is not due but paid in advance also will not include in the profit and loss account. Okay, thank you very much. Please wait for next lecture.